You will see that I repeat certain themes in different ways. I'm picking up on the idea of Mary Magdalene as an earth goddess in her grotto, in touch with the earth. I'm turning her into a wild woman, and I'm using her iconic red hair. And the marks in the background are designs and symbols that come from Maria Gimbutas's excavations and research into the gods and goddesses of old Europe. But you can also see that she's bleeding down her leg. Now, of course, in those days, I don't think women had pads or tampons, so I think menstruation was a lot more visible than it is today. And part of my research brought me to a wonderful book that was compiled by a Spanish scholar, Ana Fedela, who wrote a book searching for Mary Magdalene. And she wrote this book about modern day pilgrims who go to Mary Magdalene's sacred sites in the south of France and rituals that they perform there. And the ritual that really resonated with me was young women go there into the wild forest that surrounds the cave at Saint Baume, and they bleed into the earth. So they and the women report that in doing that it creates a participation mystique between their bodies and the earth, and it creates that sacred link. And in that image there, I have a sort of facsimile or the idea of her inside an enclosure, like inside the womb of the earth. And I'm turning her into the Black Madonna there, because the Black Madonnas of Europe that were unearthed in the 11 and 1200s were often told to have been dug out of the earth, like a farmer was plowing a field and his plowing animal unearthed this little dark statue. So that is also the connection to the earth, the earth mother, the great goddess. And these are all drawings that were also done 20 years ago, and they all play with the idea of the earth mother or the earth goddess. And in fact, the model who sat for me here, Stella Sanchez, has an Inca grandmother, so she's half Spanish, half native Mexican. So you can see in her profile, it is that sort of ancient, archaic look. And I'm using the three colors in here, the earth, the rock, the plant and vegetation, and the oceans and the water. So those are the colors I use. And then here at the very end, I have Tara pouring out compassion. So it's again another iteration of Tara. And in this fold out drawing here, I have Tara's vow inscribed. Red Moon Passage, which was something I did many years ago, but after I read about the pilgrims that go to Saint Baume and offer their menstrual blood to the soil, I thought, isn't that now appropriate? I have the sacred marriage as the conjuncto, which is the alchemical understanding of the marriage between the sun and the moon and the integration of opposites, how the one needs the other. It's like the yin and yang.